Welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to create the fastest car ever in Car Mechanic Simulator 2018. That's right, everybody. Welcome back to my beautiful garage with the green floor. So good. All right, so the plan of today is to go to the junkyard or to the auction and get a super cheap slash reasonably good car that we can then upgrade to the max and hopefully create the fastest car ever. All right, so let's get out of here and let's start with the junkyard. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have made it to the junkyard. Now, I want to find a car that already by itself is like a sports car, of course. Because, ladies and gentlemen, we want to create the fastest car in the game. We're going to tune it like crazy. What is this thing? This looks like an Opel or something like that. I don't know. By default, it doesn't have to be the fastest, so we're not going to get like a Bugatti or anything like that. But hey, if we find a Ferrari, which are also really fast, I think we'll go, what the... Wait, what is this? Is this what I think it is? The Centenario? Is this a Lamborghini? Did we just find a Lamborghini in the junkyard? So I'm taking a quick look inside. It seems like we're missing the engine, which is not a great thing. I believe this thing has a V12. Oh my goodness. But we're missing a lot of parts here, guys. We are missing a lot of parts, but this is a good potential. This could actually be or become one of the fastest cars in the game. Right now, it probably won't drive, but I mean, we can give it a try. But before we decide on this one, let's keep on looking, and there might be another car for sale in the junkyard that we could potentially use for our project. All right, so we have some really bad cars over here. No, thank you. Oh, this is a cool one. This is like an old timer. I mean, I do like the look of it, but I don't think it's gonna create the fastest car in the game. Let's be honest. Do we have anything else over here? I don't think so. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there's only one thing we can do. And that is buy the Lamborghini. I can't believe we found a Lamborghini in the junkyard. Looks so good. All right, so let's buy the car. And what's the price? The car value is only $14,000. Yo, I'll take that any day. It's got 15,000 kilometers on it. The global body condition and everything is quite low. It's got a V12 in it, or it needs a V12 at least. And doesn't seem to be in a very good state, which is fine. We're gonna fix it up and we are gonna create the fastest car in the game. Let's buy this vehicle. And here it is, ladies and gentlemen, our Lamborghini. Man, it looks a lot better in my garage than it does in that junkyard. This is a beautiful machine, though, I gotta say. What do we got in the front? Okay, it looks like we got a nice battery and nothing else. There's not much storage space in this thing, but hey, it's a Lamborghini, y'all. Oh, look at these doors, by the way. They go up. All right, so what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to put this thing on a lift and we're gonna completely strip it. So let's move the car to a car lifter. There we go. All right, so like I said, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna strip this car completely. So let's start off with the wheels. And what we gotta do for that is take out every screw individually. These are some nice rims, though, I gotta say. I gotta take a good look at the condition they're in, and maybe I could even fix them up. All right, there we go. Time for our final wheel. Couple screws more to go. And voila! Perfecto! All right, we're just gonna have to take everything out, really. Our battery. I'll take that thing. I gotta put it in charge. Okay, where's the charger? Here it is. Charge battery. This one. Yes. All right, take off the door. We don't have a window either. What about some fenders? Some side fenders? Do we have them? Oh, we have one here. Wait, it's called the right rear door window. That doesn't make any sense, but fine. All right, to me, kind of looks like we stripped everything from the outside. Now, what we gotta do is strip it from the inside, aka literally get rid of everything, which is like the easiest part. Putting everything back together, however, is a little bit, trickier. But like you guys probably know by now, this is not the first Car Mechanic episode I've done. I've done some before, and you guys seem to love those. Look at all these rusty parts, by the way. They are disgusting. Wonder how long that Lamborghini has been there. Kind of feels like it's been there for a while. All right, we're almost done at stripping everything out of the car, at least in the front part. The back part is definitely going to be the hardest part because the engine in this Lamborghini is in the rear of the car. All right, as you guys can see, there's literally nothing anymore here. I mean, we can look straight through because there's no hood anymore either. All right, time to just clean up the back, and then we can start building a new engine. All we got left is an engine block, and to take that thing out, we need, like, a crane, because, guys, you know, I do lift, but Engines are a little bit too heavy for me.
All right, so we're gonna put it on our car lifter. Just gonna click on this one, and we're just gonna say, pull the engine out of the car. And that's it. Now, the engine is gone. I gotta say, the car is looking pretty good right now. Now that we've stripped it all, we can start cleaning it up. But before we do that, I would say, let's start focusing on our new engine. So we've got an engine stand over here, and what we're gonna do is we are going to create an entire new V12. It's gonna take some time. All right, so what we need is a V12 DOHC, all right? All right, so stock, this engine will be 800 horsepowers. We could probably tune that to about 1,000, and then we can mess with the gearbox and potentially create the fastest car in the world. All right, so let's browse the internet and buy all the parts that we need in our V12. All right, so I'm just gonna type in V12 in the search engine, and these are all the things I'm gonna need for my V12, plus some other things that other engines have as well. So I'm just gonna buy a bunch of things. As you guys can see, it is pretty expensive, so I'm a bit scared. All right, there you go. I think I pretty much bought one of everything. We do need some more camshafts, though. We probably need like 10 of those, of these ones as well. There's also a tuning shop where I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna type in V12, and these are all the improved versions of the V12 parts. So obviously engine heads, exhaust things. They add a lot. They add a lot. All right, so now that we bought some parts, let's see if we can put an engine block on this thing. Yes, we can. Moving on, we need an oil filter. Wait, we don't have an oil. We don't have a V12 oil filter. Great. Power steering. We do have that one. Just screw that one in there. We need an alternator. And this, see, this is like a tuned part. 1.5% better than the other ones. This is already going great. Camshaft V12. We need some pistons. And we're just gonna use our customizable ones. There you go. We need that extra juice, you know what I mean. All right, there we go. I bought the oil filter. I can put this one on right now. It's a nice and, what is that? Pink one. Nice. All right, time for the engine head. Now, this one is gonna add 7%. So this is a really, really good one. And obviously, we need one on the other side as well. Just, you know, gonna have to build that one in too. The intake manifold, and this one's gonna add 2%. Guys, this is going great. Look how massive this engine is. Another camshaft, okay. And then we need 2 cam gears. Do I have those? I don't remember those. Nope. Okay, I gotta buy those separately. Something I did buy was these caps. And those we need to screw in individually. It takes some time to build an engine. I'd say about 40 minutes per engine at least. And this is a V12, so this one might even take longer. All right, time to put a cover on. There you go. I feel like we missed a step. I think there were spark plugs that we had to put in as well. Maybe we can still do that though. Oh, we can, yep. Okay, and we have these special ones that add 0.13%. Hashtag worth it. All right, time to add some exhausts, obviously, plus 2%. You know, we got these special exhausts with them extra juice, you know what I mean? Another one on this side. Engine's coming along quite nicely and a lot quicker than I thought it would be, to be honest. Fuel rail, oh nice, plus 3%. A fuel filter, plus 06. The flywheel, oh, 3.5. All right, so I gotta buy some more ignition coils, and those are like the boosted ones. We need some cam gears. I think I added that one to the list. Yes, I did. Okay, we need this one. Oh, we have it, okay. Oh, a nice carbon top. An air filter, plus 1%. We need some more camshafts. I think I could put the exhausts on, right? Yep, I have some of these left. It's good to go to the shop before you start building an engine, guys. If we flip it 180, we can actually work underneath the engine. So we don't have to go back to the shop yet. And look, there's a lot of things we need to do here. A lot of rod caps. Oh, I don't have a lot of those anymore. Yeah, I need some more of these. I'm running out. And then a crankshaft bearing cap. These are just to secure the pistons. That's really what they are. Okay, let's go to the shop. I think I'm ready for that. All right, so we need cam gear. Just the normal one. Just the normal one. We need a couple of those. I believe 2 on each side, so we technically need 4. We need ignition coil. It's this one, but I remember there was a upgraded one, so we should probably go and check that one out as well. Cam shaft. I think there's an upgrade one of that one as well. A rod cap, there's probably not. A lot of rod caps. We seriously need a lot of them. Ignition coil. Here we go. There you are. I need you. Cam shaft V12. That's what we need. We need the normal one, but I'll buy a couple of B as well, because just in case. All right, so let's just continue at the top. We got to put all these rod caps on. They kind of take a long time, you know, because you got to screw them in individually, and it's just a little bit of work. There you go, rod cap done, and the oil pan will continue. Beautiful. That's actually the bottom of the entire engine. This is done. Okay, now let's rotate this thing another 180 degrees, and we're gonna flip it back up to the top, and then we can continue on this side. We need two camshafts, and I bought these extra upgraded ones. We're gonna have to cover them with all these camshaft caps. Oh, we need to buy some more of those. Darn! Thought we had enough. Okay, whatever, that's fine. Let's put the cam gear on. Four of them. Two on this side. And two on this side. Let's add in the spark plugs. I believe we have plenty of these. Okay, we quickly gotta head back to the shop to buy these camshafts. So the V12 cap. It's this one. We need a lot of them. All right, put them all on.
2,000 years later.
Okay, the last one, and then I think we'll be able to put the top on it. Yep, the head cover. Nice. All right, then we can continue finally with the ignition coil, and we have all these upgraded ones, which add some extra power into the engine, guys. The color does that, trust me. Not really how it works. I can't believe we're building an engine for a Lamborghini here, guys. Isn't that insane? Oh, and look, just what I thought. This is an AMG V12, made for the Pagani. I can't say that word. Moving on, we need a belt. We have some of these. We need the timing chain shoe. It's just to put the belt in place, really. That's what it does. Top of that, we can put a cover, which we have as well. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think I just completed building the V12 engine. I mean, I'm not exactly sure. I might be missing some parts, but it looks pretty good, I gotta say. We're gonna take it off the crate, we're gonna put it on the lift, and we're gonna lift it into our Lamborghini. But before we do that, there's a welder tool right here, and if we move that to our lifter, we can clean the rust away from the Lamborghini. Boom! There you go! Wow! The car is clean. So now we can actually put the engine in and not worry about, you know, any rusty parts touching it. All right, it's time to put the gearbox on. I don't think I'm missing any parts in the engine. If we are, I will have a look at it later because I don't see any parts missing right now. All right, let's lift the car up and try and put some pieces back together. And in just a little bit, we're just gonna have to work on some new wheels. I'm just gonna have to buy those in the shop. Before we do that, I think we should work on the actual construction of this, like the housing, which, you know, it's not looking great. We need to fix that. And any broken parts we found from the car, we can actually repair over here by just clicking a whole bunch of times. It's repairing it, trust me. Time to put everything back together where it belongs, ladies and gentlemen. And this is truly the part that takes the longest, honestly. All right, so we pretty much completed putting all the brake discs on there, and we're almost ready for the wheels. Before we can put the wheels on, we need to get some shock breakers. So we're gonna have to make some springs, all right? We're gonna join parts, a front shock breaker with a front spring and a front shock absorber cap. A lot of words, okay? So we need two ones on the front. Where's the rear one? Oh, here it is. Double shock rear. That's what I like. This takes some time. You see, it's like doing something to it. Okay, here we go. We have two 100% conditioned spring absorbers, or shock absorbers, that's what I mean. Two at the back, and then two on the front. All right, looking good. All right, so I'm pretty much ready for the wheels now. We can put some sport tires on here, but first, let's have a look at the previous ones that I had. All right, guys, so I think this is the tire that came with our Lamborghini. It is a 26.5-inch tire. We're gonna buy some new ones, and that we're gonna put on this Lamborghini. All right, so let's go to the shop. We need some nice rims. The car is obviously gonna be, you know, a nice jelly green, so which rims work well with that? Not these ones, no. Even though they look kind of cool, not the gold ones. Unfortunately, you can't actually paint rims in this game. So I'm just gonna have to go by looks. I feel like rims are always so difficult. You never really know what fits with your car, but what am I gonna do? This is the one we have now. It looks good. It looks classy, but yet fast. That's something I need as well. We're gonna go with this one. It's just, it's okay looking, don't you think? It's okay looking. Just gonna buy five of these. The Modern Rim 6. Now we're gonna have to buy tires. We're gonna buy some race tires of the same size. There you go, I think that should be it. All right, so we're in front of this machine, the tire changer. We're gonna install them together. We have the Modern Rim with a tire, that's right. And to be honest, that could look really cool. All right, time to balance the wheel as well. We have the 24, 23, I don't even remember how many inches it was. I think I bought two different sizes, I don't know. All right, time to put these rims on. We're gonna mount the 23-inch wheel. Okay, please look good, please. You know, up front they look kind of good, let's say. Yeah, they look fine up front. All right, we're just gonna keep them, and obviously they're There's still a whole bunch of body parts to put on. So once we've done that, we can take a better look at it, if that makes sense. All right, so we're actually getting really far in right now. We're almost done with the car, and we can start tuning it. Before we do that, let's find the interior cleaner. Where's that? Here you are. You know, I want the clean interior, so we're just gonna have to use it for 100 bucks. There you go, clean interior. All right, let's go to the shop and buy all the outside pieces for our Lamborghini. Because obviously it didn't come with all of them. This is gonna be expensive, okay? Lamborghini. All right, now this is gonna be the fun part, guys. We are going to assemble the car together. Let's start with the front window. Ooh, looking good. The front right door. Oh my goodness. A window here, a right side mirror, the rear door right window. That's not what it is, but fine. The hood. Woo-hoo! The front bumper. Oh my god! Jeez. All of a sudden, this car has a face. The right headlight. Oh, that's good. Left headlight. I'm gonna close the hood. I wanna see what it looks like without the hood. There you go. Oh! Oh my goodness! That is a good-looking Lamborghini! All right, so on the back, we still have some more things to add. We've got a trunk. Nice. Some trunk windows. This part. Oh, the rear bumper. Oh, whoa! We're gonna have to take the rusty Russian plate off. Yes, I said that. We're gonna make an Arkansas plate. That's not rusty. I think we're good on the outside. Wow! The rear wheels look a bit strange, but the front ones look good. All right, now for the interior, we're gonna need two seats and a steering wheel. This one and this one. Oh, that actually looks really good. We're gonna use the Pagani steering wheel, okay? How does that look? Wow! That looks fantastic! All right, let's have a look at the car status and see if we are forgetting anything right now. Everything seems to be 100%, 100%, 100%, 100%. Oh, we don't have an ABS pump, no ABS module, and no starter module. And our rear license plate is not a full 100%. Okay, and no engine cover. Oh, but we don't need an engine cover. Okay, that ABS module should be somewhere over here. The starter is next to the gearbox, right? Okay, did I buy that? Yes, I did. Okay, we have a starter, the ABS pump. We have a full new ABS pump with an ABS module. Okay, we need to buy that one. Okay, I think that should be it. Let's test out our new Lamborghini, guys. Let's try to make this the fastest car ever. I mean, it already looks like the fastest car ever. It's pretty insane. Oh my goodness. It sounds so good. All right, so place the front wheels on the brake tester. There you go. Brake, please do your thing. And 100%. Okay, every part is, of course, new, so I don't assume anything to be wrong, but if we miss, like, a screw or something, I don't know, something could go bad, all right? And it's better something goes bad in here than out on the road. Gotta say, though, this interior, man, it is so good. Okay, everything seems to be good, 100%. Which means we can take our baby to the paint shop. Welcome to the paint shop, my favorite Lamborghini ever. We're gonna make you nice and green. Huh, can I only change the line and make it green? Is that it? I mean, it looks cool, I gotta say, but I'd like it to be the other way around. Okay. Okay, I don't think you'll be able to actually change the black into green. Okay, but that's fine. We have green lines everywhere now. That looks pretty dope too. It's time for the reveal. How many horsepowers does our new Lamborghini have? And can we possibly make it the fastest car in the game? Okay, here we go. It's making a lot of noise! It's making a lot of noise! Oh, those are some good lines! Come on! 1,130 horsepower! A 17% gain over the stock 667! What? That's insane! This might be the fastest car I've ever created, guys. Wow! Over 1,000 horsepowers and a top speed right now of 374 kilometers an hour. That is really fast. Let's change that up a little bit and hopefully we can hit about 430-ish. That's this in miles per hour, and that should kind of make it the fastest car in the world. Wow. Guys, we've tuned the car. There's only one thing we can do right now, and that is bring it to our test track, where we are going to see if this is going to be the fastest Lamborghini ever, or car ever in the world. So on the top left, we can see our timer, 0 to 50, 0 to 100, 0 to 200, 0 to 300. The miles per hours is this. Let's get started. Come on! Come on! We can do this. Woo! Oh my goodness! 1.9 seconds to 100 kilometers an hour! What? This car is definitely the fastest car in the world! Oh my god! We're almost about to hit 300 kilometers an hour, only in about 15 seconds, and our top speed is... Our top speed is 350 kilometers an hour. Well, I gotta say, that must be the fastest car I have ever seen. Ladies and gentlemen, I wanna thank you so much for watching this video. I just created the fastest car in the world in Car Mechanic Simulator 2018. If you enjoyed this video and wanna see more Car Mechanic Simulator, drop a like on this. At 10,000 likes, I'll upload another one, and I'll catch you then.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, click on that subscribe button, and also make sure to check out the new exclusive Jelly Army t-shirts on jellystore.com.